Okay, this is going to be chapter 6 of the Hux. No, sorry. Boko X Hux sister listener. So yeah, it's made by Crimson_A on Wattpad. So let's begin. Chapter 6. A mistake made. The next day you woke up feeling lighter and enthusiastic. Keigo walked into your room in his uniform slash hero costume and a big smile adoring his features. Alright, my little hummingbird. Precious sis. Baby wings, chicken bee. You cut him off. Why are you so embarrassing? You covered your face with the blanket. Keigo just laughed. He always called you nicknames to make fun of you. Okay, I'm sorry. But it's a new day at UA! He screamed and threw his hands in the air, while his wings stretched out. I know. So I'm going to get ready and you should... You gestured towards the door as Keigo finally got the message. Oh, sure, I'll just... Yeah, you know, okay. I'm going downstairs, so yeah. He smiled awkwardly and he slowly left. You sighed and got out of bed, stretching. After brushing your teeth and showering, you reached out for your uniform in the cupboard and stuffed your notebooks in your bag. YM! Keigo screeched loudly, making you cringe and cover your ears. He was loud, almost as loud as a hawk. Rushing downstairs, excited for the new day and experience, while tucking in your shirt and adjusting your tie. Yeah, I'm down. You stopped short and you saw Shoto coming through the door. Good morning, Wayan and Mr. Takami, he said formally. He sucked Shoto. Just call me Keigo. You're like my family anyway. Your brothers requested. Shoto nodded, and that was when you decided to pinch it. Okay, why is Shoto here? Here? Why is Shoto here? You ask as you raise an eyebrow and cross your arms. You suspected a very good reason, though. Keigo rubbed the back of his neck shyly and gave you a close eye smile. Well, you see, sis, I thought having Shoto with you as you walked to school would be faster, he said nervously. You thought he would still be protective, even after the last night's talk. Shoto cleared his throat and spoke to you. Please don't be upset, Wayan. He only called my father for this, so no one needs to know. You walked towards the door and pondered the situation. Shoto, you obvious idiot. People already think we're dating. You thought, bawling as you hugged Keigo and fixed your bag and your back. It's fine, right now I don't care, I just want to go to school, you said and smiled slightly at Keigo. Aw, thanks, hummingbird, he said, ruffling your hair and you sweating his hand away. We should get going, goodbye, Keigo. Wrong person. We should get going. Goodbye, Keigo. Shoto said as he walked you out and fixed your hair. Walking down the street, Shoto smirked at you. So how did he find out? He said, asked smugly. Uncle Sawa snitched. Thanks for reminding me. He's going to have a piece of my mind. He said, glaring at the sidewalk. Shoto chuckled and bumped you slightly. You were nearing school when you felt something was weird. You slowly came to a stop and looked around. You didn't see anyone, just some bushes rustling, probably from the wind. Shrugging, you caught up with Shoto and continued your journey. Time skipped to arriving in at class. Hey, Wayan, Mina greeted you cheerfully. Where did you get our UA on? She asked, and you I can't speak today, sorry. We currently nodded while laughing at how excited she was. Ooh, why did you and Todoroki boy walk to school? She cooed, while gesturing to the bicolored haired teen across the room. Mina, our families are close, that's all. You said firmly, as she seemed satisfied, for now. Time skipped to lunch. We finished English class, and the other course subjects, too. They were quite boring, to say the least. We pondered whether or not to switch with Shoto or Mina, but Shoto insisted you sitting with Mina, so you did. We walked over to the Baku squad table. Hey guys, mind if I join you? He asked politely. Mina moved over and pushed Kishima a bit too. Zero was directly in front of you as you sat down, and Kaminari was next to Katsuki at the end of the table. You noticed Katsuki staring at you. Katsuki, are you alright? Inquiring about your friend's comfort. Kaminari spat out his noodles at half as Katsuki scoffed and Kishima rushed to get him to drink water. Did you just call him? You looked confused. Katsuki? Yes, I did. Holy crap, she just said it again. Is she still alive? Zero piped. Oh, shut up. It doesn't mean anything. Katsuki pounded his fist onto the table. Okay. Kishima said. Katsuki. He finished, and you swore you saw a smoke of Katsuki's ears. Don't call me that shitty hair, he screamed. As Katsuki was yelling at the three other boys, Mina nudged you and you leaned closer to so she can whisper in your ear. Do you think Bakugo is hot? She asked. You blushed furiously. Trying to keep your composure, you didn't even realize you were losing. He stuttered. Mina let out a squeal and cuffed her cheek. You have a crush, she said. Unfortunately, the boys heard and stopped arguing. Can we not effing talk about the effing dumbass? He looked as if he was pounding. You were confused, so you asked, who? He scoffed and rolled his eyes at you. That effing Canadian flag you hang out with. We all know you are so close. He said spitefully. How would you know? You asked as you furrowed your eyebrows. Didn't he effing walk you to school? He even laughed with you and bumped you all buddy buddy today. Bumped you all buddy, but he covered his mouth harshly as he realized he was realized what he had just said. You were furious as hell. That's what you felt this morning? He was spying on you? Katsuki, you were spying? He yelled. Everyone seemed taken back from your outburst. I wasn't effing spying, I was observing. He yelled back. You scoffed and walked away, leaving Bakugo a bit surprised. He saw you were genuinely upset, and for some reason he did care. He didn't like not seeing your beauty, idiotic smile. Of course, he didn't admire that to himself though. I effing messed up. He mumbled. I'll fix this just because I don't want her to hold him back in training later, because she's all depressed. So that was the part. I'm so sorry for stuttering a lot. My voice won't like function today, and if I sometimes just get really quiet, it's either because I see a notification pop on my phone, like a comment, and just so you guys know, I see all of your comments, so if you want to ask me something or want to request something, I see the comment. Or it was quite, it was because I thought my mother was going to go in the room, and she had done it like so many times. And a little, the last thing I'm going to say before I end this video, I just want to say thank you to all of you guys saying that you guys like my voice or my accent. I've never really liked it because I have a friend that is really good at speaking English, and she sounds like she is from one place that you guys speak English from, for example, England. But if you are from where I am from, you can definitely hear where I'm from. With Miss Lotte, it goes like an accent. But no further ado, I'll end the video here. Bye!